Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to talk a little bit about some of the tools that we use inside of the Tradigital 2D Effects class. Namely, I'm going to be talking about Adobe Animate, Toon Boom Harmony, and Adobe After Effects. There are also some free options out there or open source options. We don't currently have lessons for those, but we definitely have plans to do something in that area during the early access phase. Right now, what I'm going to do is express all of the pros and cons of each software package. But before I dive right into that, I guess I should mention, it doesn't really matter what the pros and cons of each software package are. Honestly, the key is that you know the fundamentals and the artistic abilities that are gonna transfer from software to software. Now, yes, there are some ups and downs and we're gonna go into that, but really I can't emphasize this enough. If you don't watch any more of this video, the most important thing for you to realize is it does not matter which software package you use if you don't know how to animate. And if you really know how to animate, then again, it doesn't matter which software package you use, your animation is gonna look amazing. I've seen great work come out of all of these software packages, and I've also seen terrible work come out of all these software packages. Okay, so enough of that, on to what's amazing and not so amazing about each software package. Okay, so first off, we've got Adobe Animate CC. Now, if you've ever used Adobe Flash in the past, honestly, there haven't been a lot of major updates to really change what's going on with the software today. You're looking at a lot of the same usability as far as being an animator goes. My favorite thing about Adobe Animate is that it's widely available. That's the number one thing. It's installed on any school computer or studio computer that already has the Adobe Creative Cloud on it, which is just great to have it right there at your fingertips in so many different places where you're going to be doing your animation work. The other thing that I like about it is that it's actually very clean and easy to use. It's a nice intuitive interface and everything is relatively straightforward to learn and not a lot of craziness going on there as far as complexity goes. Beyond that, it is used on a wide variety of major productions still. I was animating in Adobe Animate on Netflix, the Netflix show Arlo, which is really cool. Like they're still using it even in TV and film animation. Also, it is very stable. It's nice and consistent. It doesn't crash very often at all. It loads very quickly, so it's very optimized. And that ends up just being a really, really nice bonus when you're working on maybe a lower end machine or something of that nature. You want to have software that loads quickly and that doesn't lag and it's not going to keep crashing on you. Now with all this great stuff, there's also a few drawbacks to Adobe Animate. And most of the drawbacks, I would argue, don't really start to manifest until you get much more experienced with the software and as an animator. And once you start recognizing what some of the other animation packages out there offer. What I'm really trying to say is Adobe Animate is great for a beginner, but as you go further along, you might find yourself wondering, maybe I should switch to something else to get a few more features that I want. For instance, the brush tool leaves something to be desired. I know they recently made an update to the brush tool, which gives it a few more features, but the experience of painting as an artist, oh, I just wish it was better. I just so badly wish sometimes that they would make an update to that one tool and then I would love so much more about it. But then there's other things too, like the flipbook export process, which has largely been ignored or disregarded for us game developers. And then there's things like blur and glow, which it's not the best pipeline. You end up finding a lot of workarounds to try to even make it happen. So yeah, overall, I would say Adobe Animate, great for the newcomers, really simple and great to learn. But if you're more of a power user and you want to really dive deep on the craft of 2D effects, there are some better options out there for you. Next up, we've got Toon Boom Harmony. Now, Harmony is certainly the industry standard for 2D animation. It's used in the vast majority of productions around the world. All the major 2D effects and 2D character animation productions that you see happening are typically going to be done in Toon Boom Harmony. Like I said, some stuff's being done in Animate, but Harmony is definitely the leader of the pack. So that's fantastic. It's fully featured with all kinds of tools. This thing is a powerhouse, especially if you get the Toon Boom Harmony Premium package. You get not only the frame by frame animation components, but also the compositing component as well, that lets you do some amazing effects using their node-based editor. That's right, they have a full-featured node-based compositing tool built into Harmony, which is just awesome. Also, the company is just a joy to work with. I'm in touch with them a lot, and they're a great company. They really listen to the artists, and they do a lot to stay engaged with the animation community, making sure they add lots of good focus on the artists. It's basically going to have all the same pros that Adobe Animate has. It's going to be pretty easy to learn and pick up and get into. It's going to run very efficiently, and it's not going to crash as often with its stability and really solid, high quality updates and attention to detail. Now, all that being said, of course, it's going to have its drawbacks as well, although admittedly not quite as many as Adobe Animate, but still might be enough to deter you. First and foremost is going to be cost. This thing is going to cost a pretty penny. It is premium software, and so it does have a premium price attached to it. I don't blame them for charging what they charge. Honestly, I think it's worth the price. It is a fantastic, fantastic tool to do 2D animation. Beyond that, there's just a couple of others. It's a little bit more complex to use, might take you a little bit more to ramp up into, but honestly, that learning curve is going to pay right off. And the way we introduce it in the class, it's not going to be too much of a challenge if you've used similar software before in the past. Then there's Adobe After Effects. Now this thing is awesome. Just like Adobe Animate, it's already installed anywhere that you have Adobe Creative Cloud. And beyond that, it's a powerhouse. It's just a total powerhouse. It does compositing and motion graphics at a level that you see in major productions everywhere. This thing is so widely used and such a great tool to have on your tool belt. I definitely thought it critical to include a whole section on post-processing and motion graphics, just because I love the stuff that can come out of After Effects. Toon Boom does a lot of the same things in its compositing tool as well, don't get me wrong, but definitely you see a lot of places using After Effects. Now, it's also very stable, and it's also pretty optimized, which is important when you're working with really high resolution video footage. You're gonna find, even in some of our videos, we run into some trouble because the file sizes and the frame calculations and all these effects that are happening can tend to chug on your RAM. But the nice thing about After Effects, and we're gonna show you how to do this, is that you can find workarounds to make your files usable, even if your computer isn't a total monster, able to handle anything you throw at it. You can tone some settings inside of After Effects to accommodate for those workflows. Okay, but there are some cons to this. The biggest one being that it has these paid plugins. And we're still gonna teach you how to use the paid plugins, because we know that on a studio budget, you're still gonna be able to use them for the productions you're working on. But oftentimes the free versions of them are gonna have watermarks that they put over your work. So for student work and that sort of thing, you're definitely gonna be able to really impress with some visual effects that look amazing, but you're gonna have to deal with either the watermark or some limited features on a few of the plugins. And then beyond that, I will admit After Effects is a complex tool. There's a lot of tiny little buttons and a lot of hotkeys that you need to know that are hidden in weird, obscure places. It's not really built for a pure artist that doesn't really like to bother with technical tools. It is, at the end of the day, a compositing tool that is highly technical. So the learning curve is a bit steeper on this one, which I would say is a bit of a drawback, but also allows a lot more complexity in what you're able to do, which I guess applies to the plugins thing as well. You're able to do a lot more cool stuff with it. It's just you end up paying more money, or in the case of the tool being complicated, spending more time figuring out how the heck to get it to do what you want it to do. And then there's a handy little tool inside of Blender called Grease Pencil. Now, Grease Pencil is amazing because this thing is a fully featured 2D animation tool inside of a massive 3D animation tool. So why is it so great? Well, first off, it's open source and free. That's F-R-E-E, free, which is a whole lot cheaper than all the other software that we've been talking about. And the nice thing about that is that with it being open source, it gets regular updates from a very passionate community of developers and users. So why I think this software is so cool is that it does so many different things, right? Like, it has full integration with the 3D side of Blender, which means you can do some pretty brain-bending stuff like animating 2D on 3D surfaces. You can do like all the compositing and the post-processing stuff that comes built into Blender as well, which is extremely powerful. And it's just great. The features are massive with Blender. Now, with that is the downside, because if you're a new user and you're not really that accustomed to animation software at all, I actually would not recommend that you dive right into Blender for its complexity. Just to animate in Grease Pencil, there's a lot of things that you have to work around and figure out and know about Blender, the greater software package. And that's a very complex tool that takes some time to learn. Don't get me wrong, it's a very powerful tool, but it's maybe not the most geared towards the beginner. So you're gonna run up against that if you do decide to dive into Blender for the free. You're gonna have to spend some of your time to make up for that, like most things. But also you wanna consider how powerful your computer is, because even though you're gonna be animating in just 2D effects in the class, you still have to run a full 3D engine, a full 3D software package in the background to do that. So just be ready to see whether or not your computer can handle that. There are some other free options. Namely, I'm talking about OpenTunes. OpenTunes is great. It's very straightforward, has the same benefits as Adobe Animate, easier to learn, lots of great documentation, can do all kinds of things. It has a very nice tool set. It's pretty good. One of the cons that I read about on the forums is that it's not as stable from patch to patch. So you are gonna run into some issues with either optimization, like is it gonna run smoothly on your low-end machine? And it might crash from time to time, but hey, you can't beat free, right? So OpenTunes is another one that I would recommend checking out. And then we've got our honorable mentions, namely TV Paint, Clip Studio, and Photoshop. Now, these are awesome software packages for animating as well. Yes, Photoshop can animate. It actually has an Animate Tools panel if you pull that open. But I just won't be diving into those because honestly, we've covered so much software already. I didn't want to confuse you guys with just this overload of software. Like I said earlier on, it's more about the craft, not as much about the tool. I will also mention Unreal Engine and Unity Engine are going to be used in the class. Now, those are game engines in their own right, where we just import the 2D assets into that and we make that a full-fledged effect. More information on that to come in a later video. But yeah, so that pretty much covers all the 2D tools. Please let me know if there are any that I missed that I definitely need to cover. I'd be happy to hear about that. So there you go. Now, like I said, outside of compositing, it doesn't really matter which tool you prefer. As long as you practice and you keep going at it, stick with the lessons, you're going to become a good animator. And then over time, you'll figure out which tool is best for you based on the price, based on the complexity and the tools that it offers, and you're going to be awesome at animating. I've had this experience as I've hopped around from tools to tools in the industry, and I know that you can too. I'm just excited to see all the cool animation that you make. I'm not going to ask you what you use to make it. I'm just going to know that you are practicing your animation skills. So yeah, get out there and get animating, and I'll see you in the lessons.